I thought I'd take the car through the car wash before I test full self-driving beta version 10.8 again. All right, so I've completed a camera recalibration and I've gotten the vehicle washed. So all the cameras should be clear. We're gonna go ahead and check this route again. This is the same route that I followed last week in the video where I had several autopilot disconnects caused by system error. So we're gonna go ahead and activate autopilot right here. And we'll follow the same route to the Pablo Center, downtown Eau Claire. Again, the car navigates the intersection very well. That's a definite improvement that I've seen over the updates of full self-driving. The other issue we had previously was phantom braking, particularly on this stretch of the road when we came upon the fire hydrants. And I noticed that that's been improved as well. We'll see how it does through the remaining fire hydrants. Good, so far no issues. So continue on our route. And as we go through this, we're going to be coming up on the point in about 30 seconds where the first fail occurred. We'll see if it fails again. And if you didn't see the video last week, the failure that occurred just said on the bottom, auto steer aborted due to system error. And that was the point where the failure occurred. I didn't see it occur there, but it did change lanes. Not really sure why it did that. Coming up on a red stoplight, and the stop rate is about how I would do it if I were driving. In about a half mile or so, we will be taking a right-hand turn to join a short four-lane highway and then turn northbound to follow our route to downtown Eau Claire. That lane change is automatic, all full self-driving at this point. This is nice. Nice gradual entry into the turn. Stop. Cameras are looking. No traffic coming. Safe to proceed. That was very well done. It's a little bit of phantom braking right there. I'm not sure why the vehicle slowed down. I didn't see any hazards present. And here we'll be exiting onto Hastings Way, Business 53 northbound. About the same entry into this turn, and again, about the same drive speed, a little slower than I would take it. So if you haven't seen last week's video, I'll post a link to it in the description below. You can check it out. Lane change is good. We're coming up on another point of autopilot or full self-driving failure. Here in about 50 yards or so. All right, and that went pretty well. So far, so good. Knock on some fake wood here. Hopefully the trip continues without any issues. Not sure if you saw that in the camera, but the wheel pretty much spun hard to the left. Had a little difficulty navigating that turn, but it did execute. I did not have to intervene. All the distance is set to 2, so it should catch up to this vehicle in a little bit, and then it'll keep 2 car lengths behind the vehicle. As usual, I do have my eyes on the road and my hand is on the wheel. I will see how it does. This is coming up in the third point of full self-driving disconnect that occurred previously. The other issue that we had in beta version 10.6 was that the car wanted to dive into the left turn lane here when it actually wasn't appropriate to do so. And so I noticed that it just went through that perfectly normally. And so far everything is still looking pretty good. All right, in a little bit we'll be taking a right-hand turn onto Farwell Avenue. That was really good. So that car was parked actually into the lane, and my Tesla navigated just a little bit to the left to overtake it. lane change into the left lane. We'll be turning left onto Lake Street. We'll see if this left turn is any better than the previous one. In the last left turn, it was a little awkward turning, and in a previous video at this left-hand turn, it actually ran up on the curb. A little bit of difficulty navigating, and I think that was because there's some hard-packed snow that was not cleared out of the intersection yet. And this is the final stretch of our journey. This is where I had two autopilot failures, or two full self-driving failures previously. Again, the car is following a little bit close to the right-hand side. I tend to hug the center line when I'm driving next to parked cars in case somebody darts out from a car or suddenly opens up their car door without looking. And here we are at our destination. So all in all, today's drive went pretty well. I actually thought that the car handled a lot better than it did previously. I'm very pleased with full self-driving version 10.8 after the camera recalibration. So if you have any issues when you're driving, the first suggestion I would have would be to recalibrate your cameras and make sure that the camera sensors are clean. That's all I have for today's video. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.